Let's make a prayer. Come in the name of our Lord Jesus. We humble before you this morning. We acknowledge the oppression that is here. We are indeed so grateful that you have honored us so much, O God. As we stand in your presence today, we demonstrate our confidence in you. We declare that you alone are God, and there is none besides your Father. We are grateful that we are associated with you, that we are your children, O God, that you call us sons and we call you Father. In the name of our Lord Jesus. And as we humble before your feet this morning, we are asking one thing, that you may speak to us in a way that we are able to understand. You may speak to each one of us in a way that we are able to understand. That we may comprehend your purposes concerning us this morning. We are indeed so grateful that you appear before us, O God. And this morning you are with us once again. We declare a complete open heaven this morning. And we pray for more outpouring of your presence and your Holy Spirit upon each one of us, O God. We pray for your abundance in our midst, O God. In the name of our Lord Jesus. Father, we worship and adore you. In Jesus' name we pray and believe. Amen. We may take our seats. Thank you, praise and worship team. You can take your seat also. I want to thank God for this wonderful opportunity. I do not take it for granted that we are here this morning. But it's within God's purpose and God's intention that this morning we may be in this place. I'm so grateful for the time we've been here. We have been experiencing great things in the presence of God. Those of you who are not around, don't worry, you'll partake of the grace that God has released upon our lives. Praise the Lord. Maybe those of you whom we may not have met, I want to say my name is James Okinda. I'm born again. I'm here with the team known as Lamb Team. Living out of Ministry of Prayer International. We are a team that believe in prayer. And our mandate is to ensure that the current church prays and they live in the purposes of God. We believe in the revival and the awakening of our current church, that we may be strengthened in the power of God to advance the kingdom of God and overcome the enemy completely, so that the purposes of God may be born in our lives and we may live in the destiny of which God has called us to live in. That is our mandate. Maybe my members, where you are, just wave to us. We'll introduce you next, and just lift up your hand and wave to us. Hallelujah. We were quite a number, others left, others are still coming in. And we bless the Lord. I want to thank my friend, Pastor, for allowing us to be here and giving us an opportunity that we are able to share. This morning I don't want to go into so much details, but I want just to build from where I stopped yesterday. Yesterday I was sharing about the art of transformational prayer. The art of transformational prayer. And yesterday we said that we are living in the last days, and we need a high volume of prayer. And I also said that we need an extraordinary prayer. Prayer that can generate enough power that will destroy the ever-growing power of darkness in our lives and in the nations of the world. Because the wickedness in the world is also increasing. Basically because the enemy knows that his days are numbered. And therefore he is working very hard to confuse the people of God and derail the purposes of God in their lives. The Bible tells us in the book of John chapter 10 verse 10 that the thief comes to steal, kill and destroy, but then Jesus came that we have life and have it more abundantly. So the enemy is trying very much to steal, to kill and destroy before the end of time. And therefore there is need on our part to also rise up in prayer and raise a high volume of prayer that will generate enough power to counter the tactics of the enemy. And yesterday I was saying like this, that things of the spirit, they don't just happen. There must be people to stand in the gap. People who can be the contact point of God to release his purposes here on earth. Praise the Lord. And I was saying that we are the people, because we form the church of God. And when Jesus was leaving this earth, at one time he said like this, that on this rock I will build a church, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. In other words, he was saying that his intention for the church was to establish a strong church. A church that is strong enough that the enemy cannot be able to conquer it. Praise the Lord. And that is our desire even in the current generation, that we establish the church which the gates of hell will not overcome. In other words, the Bible was just telling us that we are guaranteed our victory. We are guaranteed our breakthrough. And the enemy is not our match. We are high above him if we rise up in the strength of God. And then yesterday I also said that God has called us, he has commissioned us, and he has commanded us to disciple the nations. And I was saying that when we disciple the nations, it entails transforming the minds of the people and calculating in them a belief system that is aligned to the purposes of God, to allow the culture and the power of God to flow
nor in the life shall in their generation.
Kuruhusu makusudi na tamaduni za Mungu kuendelea katika maisha ya
wanadamu. Yesterday I said like this.
Jana pia nikasema
that we cannot just disciple the nations just like that.
Hatuwezi kufanya mataifa kuwa wanafunzi.
Because those nations are in bondage.
Maana mataifa mengi yako katika utumwa.
And the power of darkness will not let you just reach out to those nations and transform them.
Nguvu za giza hazitakuruhusu kuyafikia yale
mataifa. You will have to put up war.
Lazima utakuwa tayari
kupigana. A fierce war in that respect.
Na vita vikali kabisa.
Because the enemy won't just let it happen so easily.
Maana adui hataruhusu itendeke kwa urahisi.
But blessed be the name of the Lord.
Lakini jina la Bwana libariki.
Because in the Bible, in the book of 1 John chapter 3 verse 8.
Maana Yohana kitabu cha Yohana kwanza 3:8.
The Bible tells us like this.
Biblia inasema hivi.
That for this reason was the Son of Man made manifest.
Yakoba kwa sababu hii mwana Mungu akadhihirishwa.
That he may destroy the works of darkness.
Ili akaribu kazi za giza.
That he may destroy whatever the enemy had planned to destroy the purposes of God.
Akaribu chochote ambacho alikuwa anatumia kuharibu makusudi ya Mungu.
And therefore,
kwa hivyo,
when we believe in God,
tunapomwamini Mungu,
that war is already won.
Basi hivyo vita tayari tumeshabisha.
That's the implication of that scripture.
Hayo ni makusudi kila andiko.
That war is already won.
Vita tayari tumeshabisha.
Then yesterday we read 2 Corinthians chapter 4 verse 4.
Tukasoma Wakorintho wa pili 4.
And we say that the God of this world,
tukasema kwamba Mungu wa ulimwengu,
has blinded the minds of the people.
Amefanya mawazo ya wanadamu kuwa vipofu.
And I said he put in them a belief system that is contrary to the purpose of God.
Na nikasema kwamba ameweka ndani mwao tamaduni fulani ambayo iko kinyume na makusudi.
Because the Bible says like this.
Maana Biblia inasema hivi.
In the last part of that scripture,
sehemu ya mwisho ya andiko hilo,
let me just go through the last scripture. The Bible says that in whom the God of this world has blinded the minds of them which believe not. Lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them.
Hallelujah. Inasema hivi, kwa Korintho wa pili, ine. Inasema kwamba ambao ndani yao, Mungu wa dunia hii, amepofusha fikra zao, wasio amini, isozukie nuru ya injili ya utukufu wake Kristo aliye sura yake Mungu.
And I was saying that the weight of that scripture, the weight, or rather the mission of the devil lies in that last part of that scripture.
Sema kwamba kazi ya adui iko katika sehemu ya mwisho ya andiko hilo.
That lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ,
ya kwamba nuru ya injili ya Kristo,
who is the image of God,
ambaye ni mfano wa Mungu,
should shine unto them.
Ikawaangazie.
And then we also read 1 Thessalonians chapter 2 verse 18.
Tukasema pia wa Thessalonians wa kwanza 2:18.
And the Bible says like this.
Biblia inasema hivi.
Wherefore we would have come unto you even.
Ya kwamba tungekuja kwenu hiyo.
Even I Paul.
Hata mimi Paulo.
Once and again.
Mara moja na zaidi.
But Satan hindered us.
Lakini shetani alituzuia.
So I was saying yesterday.
Nilikuwa nasema jana.
That the devil will always resist the purpose of God.
Ya kwamba shetani kila wakati atazuia.
He will stand on the way of God.
Atasimama kinyume.
He will not just let it happen.
Hata ruhusu tu yatendeke.
He will oppose it fiercely.
Atapinga kabisa.
To ensure that it fails.
Hakikisha kwamba haifai.
Let me also read 1 Corinthians chapter 16 verse 9.
Tukasoma pia Wakorintho wa kwanza 16:9.
And the Bible says like this.
Biblia inasema hivi.
There is a wide open door. Just come for me. Just come after me. There is a wide open door.
Ya kwamba kuna mlango ambao umefunguliwa.
For a great work.
Kwa kazi kuu.
I'm reading from the New Living Translation. There is a wide open door for a great work.
Kuna mlango mkubwa umefunguliwa kwa kazi
kuu. How many oppose me.
Lakini wengi wananipinga.
Praise the Lord.
Wanasifiwe.
Many oppose me.
Wengi wananipinga.
In other words, they are not ready to let me do it.
Kumaanisha kwamba hawaniruhusi nitende.
So God has opened doors for each one of us.
Maana Mungu amefungua mlango kwa wengi wetu.
That we may do the work of God.
Ili tukatende kazi ya
Mungu. But if we are not careful,
lakini kama hatutakuwa makini,
the enemy stands on our way.
Adui atasimama
kinyume. And we become complacent.
Basi hatutafanikiwa.
Become complacent.
Atuza tutafanikisha hiyo kazi.
And we don't go on to accomplish the purposes of God.
Hatutazidi kukamilisha ile kazi ya Mungu.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifa.
And then yesterday I said like this.
Jana pia nikasema,
we've been called to disciple the nations.
Tumeitwa ili tufanye mataifa kwa watu.
But in Isaiah chapter 25 verse 7.
Lakini Isaiah 25 mstari wa 7.
The Bible says, and I will destroy.
Biblia inasema kwamba nitaharibu.
In this mountain,
katika mlima huu,
the face of the covering,
ile wingu ambalo linafunika,
cast over all people,
ambalo limewekwa juu ya watu.
And I was saying when the Bible talks about all people,
na nasema Biblia inapozungumza kuhusu watu,
it is referring also to the nations.
Inaongea pia juu ya
mataifa. The Bible uses the word all people interchangeably with the nations.
Biblia inapozungumza kuhusu watu wote inazungumzia mataifa.
And also sometimes if you say that statement you imply tribes.
Pia inatumia neno hilo
to imply tribes.
Kuzungumzia makabila.
Praise the Lord. And sometimes it can even use that statement to imply individuals.
Pia inaweza kuzungumzia neno hilo kuzungumzia mtu.
And I was saying yesterday,
nikasema
that we even in our personal level we are nations.
Sisi wenyewe binafsi pia tu mataifa.
And I refer to the story of Jacob and Esau.
Nikazungumzia habari
ya Esau. I refer to them that there were nations in the womb of Rebecca.
Ambao Biblia inasema kwamba walikuwa mataifa katika tumbo la
Rebecca. Nations that were fighting one another.
Walikuwa wanapigana wenyewe kwa wenyewe.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sisi.
So the Bible is saying in Isaiah chapter 25 verse 7.
Biblia inasema katika Isaiah 25:7.
That the nations have been covered by a cloud of gloom.
Ya kwamba mataifa yamefunikwa na wingu la giza.
Other version refers to it have been covered by a shroud of darkness.
Na kana ingine inasema kwamba mataifa yamefunikwa na wingu la giza.
Other nation say they have been covered by a veil.
Na kana ingine inasema kwamba yamefunikwa na pazia.
Because of what they subscribe unto.
Kwa sababu kile ambacho wameitanishwa
na. And I was saying yesterday,
nikasema jana,
the activity that happened here on earth,
kazi ambayo inafanyika hapa duniani,
will determine the spiritual realm that is high above that particular place.
Kisa tathmini kile ambacho kinatendeka kwa ulimwengu wa kiroho.
If the people who live in a given locality,
kama watu ambao wanaishi mahali,
subscribe so much to wickedness,
wataingia sana katika mambo ya
uchawi. Then the rulers in that particular place are principalities and powers of darkness.
Basi watawala wa mahali pale ni wachawi.
But if they subscribe to righteousness,
lakini kama watakuwa wanafanya mambo ya uchawi,
doing the worshiping of the Lord the way we are doing it today,
na kumwabudu Mungu kama vile
the powers that reign in the atmosphere in the spiritual realm, then there are righteous principalities.
Basi nguvu zinazofanya kazi sehemu ya juu, basi
in the spiritual world,
maana katika ulimwengu wa
roho, we have the physical, we have the wicked principalities and the righteous principalities.
Tuna nguvu za giza na nguvu za haki
that rule in given regions,
ambazo zinafanya
kazi on the behavior of the people who live in that area,
kulingana na tabia za watu wanaishi mahali pale.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sema.
That's what the Bible is saying.
Ya maana Biblia inasema,
there is a covering that cover the nations.
Kuna kifuniko kimefunika taifa.
Because they subscribe to the prince of this world.
Maana wametanishwa na mamalikia wa dunia
hii. But then in verse 8, when you read that down there, the Bible talks about, I will destroy.
Biblia inasema kwamba nitaharibu.
I will destroy the shroud.
Nitaharibu kile
kilicho. Our God is willing to destroy that cover that is covering the nations.
Kumaanisha Mungu amekusudia kuharibu kile kifuniko kinachofunika mataifa.
He desires that the people may be set free.
Anatamani watu wawekwe huru.
And yesterday I was saying,
jana pia nikasema,
that when we are born again,
wakati tumeokoka,
we carry the presence of God.
Tunabeba uwepo wa
Mungu. And the extent of the presence of God in our lives,
na ule uwepo wa Mungu
is directly proportional to the level we commit ourselves to God.
Utalinganishwa na vile tunajitolea kwa
Mungu. I normally tell people like this,
wanaambia watu hivi,
if you go to God in a big way,
unapoenda kwa Mungu kwa njia
kubwa, God will come to you in a big way.
Basi Mungu atakujia kwa njia kubwa.
So the level of the presence of God,
kwa hivyo kiwango cha uwepo wa Mungu,
that we carry with us,
ambacho tunabeba,
is directly proportional,
basi kinalingana
na the level of our commitment to God,
na kiwango ambacho tunajitolea kwa Mungu.
And I was telling us yesterday,
nikasema jana pia,
when we are born again and we walk in the presence of God,
ambapo tumeokoka tunatembea katika
uwepo wa Mungu, a palace we have an open heaven,
basi tunakuwa na mbingu ambazo zimefunguliwa.
God is reigning in our lives.
Maana Mungu anatawala
ndani yetu. Saying that when we move around,
nikasema tunapotembea,
the spiritual realm above us,
ulimwengu wa kiroho,
is also open.
Basi tunafunguliwa.
Whenever we go, because we walk with the presence of God,
sababu tunatembea na uwepo
somewhere in the Bible.
Mahala fulani katika Biblia.
The Bible says the glory of God will fill the earth.
Biblia inasema kwamba utukufu wa Mungu utajaza ulimwengu.
And the Bible says that it fills the earth depending on the level of the Christianity and the level of the people who subscribe to God.
Na utajaza ulimwengu kulingana na kiwango cha watakatifu na kiwango cha watu ambao wametajishwa na Mungu.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
So yesterday I was saying,
jana nikasema,
that it is our responsibility to ensure that we have an open heaven. And that's what we are talking about. The art of transformational prayer.
We
pass through prayer. We open up the heavenly portals. Where the grace of God can be poured over our lives. Through prayer we connect with God. Through prayer we bring the purpose of God to happen here on earth. Depending on our level of prayer.
Kulingana na kiwango cha
yesterday.
Nikasema jana.
When you go in a region where people pray so much.
Tunapoenda mahali ambapo watu wanaomba
sana. You will experience an open heaven.
Utakisi mbingu
zote. And even the environment will experience the power of God.
Hata mazingira pia yatahisi uwepo wa Mungu.
Want to give us a testimony.
Hebu niwapatie ushuhuda.
Where I fellowship with the church.
Mahali ambapo nashiriki pale.
Some years back.
Miaka kadhaa iliyopita.
That place was a dark place.
Mahali pale palikuwa na kiza.
There was so much of immorality.
Kulikuwa na ushirika.
People were killing each other. So much of crime in that region.
Kulikuwa na dhambi nyingi watu walikuwa na
wazi. Even on the road that passes there.
Hata njia
ambazo. There were so many accidents.
Kulikuwa na ajali.
And the value of the land in that region.
Na dhamana ya nchi ile.
Was very low.
Ilikuwa chini.
I remember the land which we our church is established on.
Nakumbuka mahali ambapo kanisa letu
we bought it at around 400,000. Praise the Lord. But when we entered in that locality, we began to pray. We began to connect with God. We began to call upon the name of the Lord. Day in, day after day. Calling upon the name of the Lord. I want to tell us today, church has begun coming up in our neighborhood. Pentecostal church has begun coming up in our neighborhood. And the value of the land shot up.
Basi dhamana ile sehemu
ikaanza mimi na land we are paying right now.
Kanisa na shamba ambalo
tunalipa. Just almost the same size of the land that we have put our church on.
Sehemu tu ambayo inatoshana na kanisa maana ambapo tumejenga kanisa.
And it's going at 1.8 million.
Inauzwa milioni 1,800,000.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
What has happened?
Nini kimetendeka?
God has turned around the environment.
Mungu amebadilisha mazingira.
I was saying yesterday.
Nikasema jana.
When God comes down.
Wakati Mungu anakuja.
The vegetation will experience the power of God.
Hata mimea itahisi
then the vegetation will become luxuriant. Because God is adding value in that particular region.
Mana Mungu anaongeza thamani mahala pale.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
So I said,
nikasema,
things of God don't just happen.
Vitu vya Mungu havitendeki.
It requires somebody who understands.
Lakini vitahitaji mtu ambaye
to connect with God
and kuunganishwa
to bring the purpose of God to come to be fulfilled.
Kusababisha makusudi ya Mungu
yatimie. I asked a question.
Pia nikauliza,
are there people who pray in this world?
Je, hakuna watu ambao
is the church not praying currently?
Ama kanisa sisi,
is there not so many keshas being held in our churches?
Je, hakuna keshas zinafanyika?
Is there no fasting being carried in our churches?
Hakuna kufunga
hema? Then why is our environment not changing rapidly?
Lakini mbona mazingira yetu hayabadiliki kwa haraka?
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
Then I said,
nikasema,
there must be something amiss.
Lazima kuna kitu ambacho hakiko.
Praise the Lord.
Well, there is a possibility.
Kuna uwezekano. Yes, we are praying.
Ndio tunaomba.
But most likely,
lakini
we may not be praying in the right manner.
Huenda hatuombi vizuri.
And I was challenging us yesterday.
Nitawatia changamoto kama
jana. That when the church slumbers,
wakati kanisa
kinazidi, the world are not slumbering.
Watu wa ulimwengu hawasinzii.
People in the dark world are not slumbering.
Watu wa ulimwengu wa giza
hawasinzii. Working extra hard.
Wanafanya kazi.
To ensure that many
wahakikishe kwamba wengi
don't move in the purposes of God.
Na hawaendi katika makusudi ya
Mungu. Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
Therefore we need to rise up.
Kwa hivyo lazima tuinuke.
And begin operating. operating in a different sphere of prayer.
Katika kanuni tofauti ya maombi.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
Are we there?
Je, tuko
pamoja? Are we together?
Tuko pamoja.
I'm saying,
nasema hivi,
that it requires somebody who understands.
Inahitaji mtu ambaye anaelewa.
If you have the Bible,
kama una Biblia,
turn with me in the book of Job chapter 32 verse 8.
Hebu angalia kitabu cha Ayubu 32 mstari wa 8.
The Bible says like this.
Biblia inasema hivi.
But there is a spirit. There is a spirit in man.
Yakoba kuna roho ndani ya mtu.
I just want to come just at the same time. There is a spirit in man.
Kuna roho ndani ya mtu.
And the inspiration of the Almighty.
Na ile udhihirisho wa Mungu mkuu.
Giveth them understanding.
Mwapatia kuelewa.
But there is a spirit in man.
Kwamba kuna roho ndani ya mtu.
And the inspiration of the Almighty.
Na ile pumzi ya Mwenyezi Mungu.
Giveth them understanding.
Imewapatia ufahamu.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
That's Job chapter 32 verse 8.
Ayubu 32:8.
In other words,
kwa maneno mengine,
that our hearts must be open to God.
Ya kwamba mioyo yetu lazima ifunguke kwa Mungu.
And to inspire us and give us understanding.
Ili tuweze kupata ufahamu.
That our hearts must be open to God.
Ya kwamba mioyo yetu lazima
ifunguke. It is God who will inspire our hearts.
Na Mungu ndiye atupatia pumzi
kwa mioyo yetu. Give us understanding.
Na tupatie ufahamu.
There is something that is coming up.
Labda kuna kitu kinakuja.
That our prayer,
maombi,
should be a prayer of understanding.
Lazima yawe maombi ya kuelewa.
A prayer that we have the knowledge of how to do it.
Maombi ambayo tutakuwa na ufahamu
jinsi ya kuyafanya. Not just simply prayer for the sake of it.
Lakini usiombe tu kwa sababu ni
prayer. There is a spirit in mind.
Kuna roho ndani ya
mtu. God gives it understanding.
Na Mungu anapatia ile roho
ufahamu. In other words,
kwa maneno mengine,
we want to make an effective prayer. Prayers must be connected to the spirit of God.
Oh, yes, nothing but the roho ya Mungu.
Yesterday I was saying,
jana nikasema,
we must reach a level.
Lazima tufike
kiwango to understand the heartbeat of God.
Maana kama tunaelewa Mungu,
we understand exactly what is in the mind of God.
Tuelewe kile ambacho kiko kwa mawazo ya Mungu.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
We are able to tap from the heart of God.
Tunaweza tukachota kwa moyo wa
Mungu. Yeah. And God to it to accomplish.
That you watch a member.
That's why God is saying. There is a spirit in man.
Kuna roho ndani.
And the inspiration of the Almighty.
Na ile pumzi ya Mungu.
Giving them understanding.
Na upatia ufahamu.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
God is the one who order our prayer course.
Mungu ndiye anapeana mwelekeo wa maombi.
When our prayer originates from God.
Wakati maombi yetu yanatoka kwa Mungu.
When our prayer is ignited, is initiated by God.
Iwapo maombi yetu chanzo chake ni Mungu.
Prayer will generate a lot of energy.
Basi hii hayo maombi yataleta nguvu nyingi.
Recently,
in my dreams,
my pastor got a very serious accident.
Mchungaji wangu akapata ajali mbaya.
They were traveling on the way from Malaba.
Walikuwa wanasafiri kutoka Malaba.
And around the region around Kambia Mwanza. Those of you who have gone to the other side of Kakamega.
One of them said to Kakamega.
The saloon which we were traveling in,
gari ndogo ambalo kuna safiria,
it happened to swerve and then roll around 3 times.
Ilibingia mara kadhaa kwa barabara.
And there were 5 people in the vehicle.
Walikuwa watu watano kwenye barabara. Katika gari.
What happened to the people who were in front had belted?
Watu ambao walikuwa sehemu mbele
had put on the belt.
Walikuwa wamefunga mishipi ya usalama.
But the people who were behind,
lakini watu walikuwa
had not put on the belt.
Hawakuwa wamefunga
mishipi. On one side of the vehicle,
sehemu moja ya gari,
there was mama, the wife of pastor.
Kulikuwa mke mchungaji.
So the vehicle rolled around 3 to 4 times.
Kwa hivyo gari likapigilia mara 3 nne.
And it stopped.
Kisha likatulia.
So God saved their lives.
Hivyo Mungu akayaokoa maisha yao.
But mom was thrown outside the vehicle.
Lakini mama akafikia gari.
You understand what I mean by that?
Unaelewa nasema nini?
Depending on the body weight,
kulingana na ule uzito,
you can understand the turbulence when the vehicle had been being driven at over 100 kilometers per hour.
Hebu jaribu kufikirie kama gari limekuwa likiendeshwa zaidi ya kilomita
100 kwa saa. Then it swerves and then it drops.
Kisha likapoteza
mwelekeo. And you are thrown outside the vehicle.
Kisha unarushwa nje ya
gari. And you are found alive. We can only associate that one to the work of God.
Tunaweza tukaunganisha tu hiyo na
kifasi. We were telling people,
tulikuwa tunaambia watu,
for man to survive,
ili uweze kuishi,
God must have commissioned the angels.
Nasema Mungu alituma malaika.
To hold high in the while still in the air,
kuwashikilia kama bado uko kwenye hewa,
and then put her down.
Kisha amweke chini hiyo mama.
Praise the Lord. So she was injured. And the people who saw her,
what about the woman?
They believed she would not survive. We learned later on, when she had been taken to the hospital, what happened is that the doctor had written her off. And although they did not say it, they only said it later, when they discovered that God had healed her. They confessed to my senior pastor that we did not want to tell you, but we knew her case had been closed. Praise the Lord. But we engaged in praying in the church. We were praying seriously. And God was ministering to us. At one time, our sister, Pastor Reba, was here yesterday, but she left. She's part of our praying team in the church. God spoke to her and said, that I've operated your pastor. I'm the surgeon of your pastor. And she's not going to be operated on. In the hospital in Bungoma where she was, they had recommended several operations because several of the bones had broken. Praise the Lord. But when the word of knowledge came to us, we prayed in that direction. I remember I was leading prayer on a Sunday morning. Praying concerning her. Then we had transferred her from Bungoma to Eldoret. And then we received a call that morning. And the doctor in Eldoret had said, we have observed her and we have ruled out an operation. Is that not great? She could not walk, she could not turn, there was nothing complete she could be able to do. It kept timing. And then they told us, we have ruled out an operation, but we are just putting her on a bed rest. They didn't understand what was happening in the spiritual realm. The prayer point was received from the heart of God. And we pray in that direction. And God responded. That is an extraordinary prayer. I remember telling people like this. That we should reach a point in our life. And this one is to every believer, not only the clergy. Where we must hear from God. Hearing from God is not only for the pastors. Or for specific people in the church. When the Bible says that the Holy Spirit which you have received will teach you all things. It does not say he will teach only to the pastors. He will teach you all the anointing you have received, will teach you all things. When the Bible is referring to the Holy Spirit, I will give you a helper. He will help you understand why are we struggling to hear from God. Because if we hear from God, we will pray with understanding. Praise the Lord. I want to read a statement here from a man called Gordon. And I want to use it to explain a few issues. He says like this. True prayer moves in a circle. Are we there? True prayer moves in a circle. It begins with the heart of God and sweeps down into the human heart.
Let
me repeat it for them who are writing. True prayer moves in a circle. It begins with the heart of God and sweeps down into the human heart.
kisha yanashuka chini kwa mioyo ya wanadamu.
So intercepting the circle of earth.
Ili yaathiri ule mzunguko ulimwengu.
So intercepting the circle of the earth.
Ili yakaingia katika ule mzunguko ulimwengu.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
Which is the battlefield of prayer. Which is the battlefield of prayer.
Ambayo ni uwanja wa vita ya maombi.
And then goes back to its starting point.
Kisha Mungu anarudia katika ile sehemu.
And then goes back to its starting point.
Mungu anarudia mahala pale pa kuanzia.
Having accomplished its purpose on the downward swing.
Baada ya kukamilisha makusudi yake hapa chini.
Having accomplished its purpose on the downward swing.
Baada ya kukamilisha makusudi yake hapa chini.
This man is saying,
huyu mtu anasema,
the true prayer begins from the heart of God.
Ya kwamba maombi ya kweli yanaanza kwa moyo wa Mungu.
And it comes down in a setting the circle here on earth.
Kisha yanakuja chini katika ule mzunguko wa
Mungu. Who is here on earth that is making part of the circle?
Kisha anapokuwa hapo chini katika ule mzunguko
wa Mungu. The heart of a praying believer.
Yako katika moyo wa ule muumini mwenye
pepo. The heart that is ready to receive from God.
Moyo ambao uko tayari kupokea kwa Mungu.
It responds in prayer.
Unaitikia kwa maombi.
Giving back to God.
Kisha inarudisha kwa Mungu.
Yako shedding with God.
Yakipiga hesabu na Mungu.
Generating and generating energy.
Yakileta nguvu.
And then it goes back to the heart of God.
Kisha inarudi sana kwa moyo.
And then God responds.
Kisha Mungu anaitikia.
Answers the prayer.
Kisha Mungu
anaitikia. And that's why the Bible is saying in Job that your dark friend.
Ndio maana Biblia inasema katika andiko ambalo tumesoma.
That there is a spirit in man.
Ya kwamba kuna roho
ndani. The inspiration of the Almighty.
Kisha pumzi Mungu mkuu.
Give them understanding.
Inawapatia ufahamu.
That the spirit of God.
Ya kwamba roho Mungu.
We help you to catch up in the circle of prayer.
Tutakusaidia kushike katika mzunguko
wa Mungu. And now the issue comes in.
Kisha hali inakuja
kwa obedience.
Utiifu.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
Sendu you are being taught about obedience.
Kwa tunazungumza kuhusu utiifu.
Obedience now comes in.
Utiifu unakuja
na Mungu. You is an intercessor.
Wewe ambao ni mwombe.
Na ile locality.
Katika sehemu ambayo
pepe. By responding in prayer.
Unatii kwa kuitikia kwa maombi.
And because it has come from the heart of God.
Na kwa sababu imetoka kwa moyo wa Mungu.
Now you are responding in prayer.
Na sasa unaitikia kwa maombi.
Yesterday in the book of Luke chapter 18 verse 1 and then verse 7 and 8.
Luke 7 na 8.
We say that Jesus
tukasema hivi.
The God is more than ready.
Ya kwamba Mungu yuko zaidi ya haya.
Under our prayers.
Kujibu maombi.
My version, the King James version says.
Lakini na kana King James inasema.
He is speedily.
Yeye
amuna haraka. Under our prayers.
Anakusikia kwa hivyo maombi.
Answering our prayers with a very high speed.
Anajibu maombi yetu kwa haraka.
Look at that.
Hebu angalia hayo.
It has been generated from the heart of God.
Imetoka kwa moyo wa Mungu.
God not under that prayer chief.
Mungu hata yajibu haya maombi.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana
asifiwe. That's why we have no choice.
Na ndio maana hatuna
chaguo. Sharpen our spiritual maturity.
Lakini tutengeneze
tumeni to have to hear from God.
Ili tuweze kusikia kutoka kwa Mungu.
To be very sensitive in the spirit.
Ili kumakinika kiroho.
Yesterday pastor was saying something.
Jana mchungaji akasema
hivi. Recently he was awoken up in the night.
Ya kwamba aliamshwa usiku mmoja.
You should pray watch.
Na kulipa na ombi hili
to pray concerning a given aspect.
Kuomba kusudikana na ahadi fulani.
It was the spirit of God.
Ni roho Mungu.
Who was awakening him.
Ambaye alikuwa anamwamsha.
He had put him back into prayer.
Na alikuwa anamweka katika hali ya maombi.
And God was able to generate enough power.
Na Mungu alikuwa na uwezo wa
kutambua the situation.
Kusudikia ni hali.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
So our prayer will gather enough energy.
Maombi yatakusanya nguvu za
kutosha. Prayers come from the heart of God.
Kama hayo maombi yanatoka
kwa Mungu. We must learn to hear from God.
Na ndio maana lazima tujifunze kusikia kutoka kwa Mungu.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
Are we there? Uko pale. That's why,
ndio maana
when you will pray over many issues in your life.
Kama umekuwa ukiombea mambo kadhaa kwa maisha
yako. The situation is not changing.
Lakini mambo ambayo unayaombea hayabadiliki.
It is the highest time to change the direction of prayer.
Basi ni wakati wa kubadilisha mwelekeo wa maombi.
I was telling my sisters recently.
Nikamwambia dada yangu hivi majuzi.
The issue which we were praying about.
Kuna kitu ambacho tulikuwa tunaombea.
And we have prayed about it for 2 years.
Na tumekuwa tukikombea kwa miaka miwili.
And I was telling them.
Nikamwambia
I have stopped to pray now directly about the issue.
Sasa nimeacha kuomba kuelekea kila kitu.
I now pray.
Sasa naomba
God speak to me.
Mungu akazungumza nami.
Open my understanding.
If I decide to understand, how am I supposed to pray about it? Which direction am I supposed to take? What is it that I've not been doing? And I'm waiting upon God. And very soon I know God will speak. Praise the Lord. Because I want it to come from the heart of God. When it comes from the heart of God, I will stand in the gap. I will complete the cycle. And I will take it back to God. And God will be able to fulfill it. Praise the Lord. Prayer is prayer. Until it originates from the heart of God.
Praise
the Lord. Many other times God will provoke our spirits. Pray over concerning some issues. But sometimes because we are seared, we are so much overcome by the daily cause. We don't respond to it.
God
will still remain God. But we shall have missed an opportunity. Because he raised another person who will handle the same issue. But
he
will miss the crown. Praise the Lord. If you are an intercessor, you are a dog that is sleeping.
Amen.
If you are an intercessor, you will prefer Petro. Come on, Mugasudio. Mesoma Benidia. You have assignments, and then you saw me in the media. When our guys are far away to come a watchman, and when our guys are far away to come a dog. That is the situation. I want to give us a scenario here as I clear something here. I'm saying that every saint is expected to be alert to the prompting of the Holy Spirit in line with God's heart to pray. When the Spirit of God prompts us, we respond right to it. That prayer is very effective. I've given us an example of the situation of our church. Praying about our mom. And we responded. In fact, the second stage was, we go in the hospital and take her home. And when we were still praying about it, the husband who is the senior pastor, without this knowledge, went to the hospital and brought her back home. Praise the Lord. As we are talking today, she's completely healed and comes to church. Because we prayed in that direction. Praise the Lord. Now, there's a man here called
Daniel
in the Bible. The Bible says, Daniel understood. You can read from Daniel chapter 10, going
to there.
The Bible talks about that Daniel understood by books the prophetic word concerning the duration of the captivity of Israel. Praise the Lord. I want to say like this, that the Spirit of God prompted Daniel to seek understanding through books. The knowledge about the Israelites who are in captivity. Praise the Lord. Now this knowledge starts at the heart of Daniel to seek God. And then when Daniel at this juncture, he becomes the earth's intersecting point. When you read that account, the Bible records that Daniel prayed for a long time. Praise the Lord. But the Bible also tells us a very interesting scenario. And from the time Daniel began to pray, the answer had already been released.
tayari ilikuwa nimeshachiwa
from the throne of God
kutoka katika kiti cha enzi
cha Mungu. But what is it that delays the anger from reaching Daniel?
Lakini nini hiki ambacho kinafanya jibu limfikie Danieli?
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
There was war in the spiritual realm,
katika ulimwengu wa
roho. But this one was to do,
maana hili kwa
with the destiny of Israel,
hatima ya wana wa Israeli.
Because this thing is Daniel understood,
kwa sababu Danieli
completely the plan of God concerning the Israelites,
makusudi ya Mungu kuelekea wa Israeli.
Definitely,
kwa hivyo
the Israel would have been delivered,
basi wana wa Israeli
already deemed
ama hivi
from captivity,
ama ondolewa katika ufungwa.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
So the angel that was bringing the anger,
kwa hivyo yule anayeka pale
the records,
Biblia inasema hivi,
that he was resisted
there, kwamba alizuiliwa
in the spiritual realm,
katika ulimwengu wa kiroho.
But because the heart of Daniel,
kwa sababu ya moyo wa Daniel,
the setting
ulikuwa unafanya
mambo yake from heaven,
ulikuwa unaangalishwa na
Daniel did not give up.
Danieli hakukata kauli.
He prayed on and prayed on and prayed on.
Akaendelea kuomba na kuomba.
And I want to say that you
nataka niseme hivi.
Yesterday I was saying,
jana nilikuwa nasema,
but because our prayers originate from the altar of our heart,
kwa sababu maombi yetu yanatoka katika mioyo yetu.
Because the Bible says,
maana Biblia inasema,
our prayers are a sweet smelling aroma before God.
Maombi yetu ni kama manukato mazuri mbele za Mungu.
Haisikii maneno.
Umeshaisikia hivi wewe?
There are sweet smelling aroma before God.
Ni manukato mazuri mbele za Mungu.
And therefore we call that originating from our hearts.
Na kwa sababu yanatoka kwa mioyo yetu.
I was saying that they are hot.
Nikasema kwamba haya maombi ni moto.
Yes, through the spiritual realm.
Na yanachoma katika ulimwengu wa kiroho.
That's why sometimes.
Na ndio maana wakati mwingine
when we begin to pray,
wakati tunaanza kuomba,
sometimes we begin with the struggle.
Tunaanza kwa kung'ang'ana.
We begin with the struggle.
Tunaanza kwa kung'ang'ana.
We get a great hit.
Wakati tunapata
we begin experiencing breakthrough.
Tunaanza kupata.
We begin experiencing breakthrough.
Tunaanza kuona
upendo. We want to pray, pray, pray.
Tunataka uombe tena na tena.
Because now our prayers are becoming hot.
Kwa sababu maombi yetu sasa
yanakuwa hot. In the spiritual realm.
Yanaingia katika ulimwengu wa
kiroho. The power of darkness.
Na kwa sababu hiyo katika dunia ya
giza. We try to resist it.
Eta wenye nguvu za giza zijaribu kuzuia.
We begin now to run away.
Naanza kukimbia.
We begin now to run away.
Anza kukimbia.
Now when you read that account,
unaposoma habari hii,
praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
Later on,
baadaye,
you discover the angel,
unagundua kwamba malaika
broke through the ranks of the enemy,
akapita katika kile kizuizi cha
adui, broke the anger to Daniel,
akaleta jibu kwa Daniel.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
I was realized when I was reading the scripture,
niligundua kwamba nilikuwa nasoma andiko,
that the angel Michael,
kwamba malaika Mikaeli,
was actually,
let me confirm it well,
was the angel Michael,
malaika Mikaeli,
was the principality in charge of Israel.
Alikuwa ngome ambayo alikuwa anashughulikia Israeli.
But he could do nothing,
lakini hangefanya lolote,
to deliver the children of Israel.
Kwa kuomba wana wa Israeli.
Praise the Lord. Who was a precious principality. He was a precious principality.
Alikuwa ngome mwenye
in charge of Israel.
Alikuwa anashughulikia
Israeli. He could do nothing,
lakini hangefanya lolote.
Because the Israelites,
maana wa Israeli,
have sinned against God.
Walikuwa wametenda dhambi.
And therefore they were in captivity legally.
Kwa hivyo walikuwa katika utumwa kwa njia ya
Israeli. The enemy,
adui,
was legally holding them.
Alikuwa amewashikilia kwa njia ya
Israeli. There is no way they will come out.
Kwa hivyo hakuna njia yoyote ambayo
wangeweza. But it required Daniel,
basi itakuwa ile
ile, to stand in the gap,
kusimama kwenye pengo,
so that he undo the legality,
ili akageuze kule kukubaliwa.
Because we will notice later on, nataka ukienda nyumbani ufike hapo mahali vizuri. We will notice later on,
tutakuwa baadaye.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
Even in the spiritual atmosphere,
hata katika hali ya anga,
there was trembling. There was change in God.
Kulikuwa na mabadiliko.
And even on the ground,
hata hapa chini,
later on there was change in God.
Baadaye kulikuwa na mabadiliko katika ulinzi.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
There's a different authority.
Kuna mamlaka fulani
that came to Jacob,
ambayo alikuwa anataka kufuzu gani.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
Because there is somebody,
maana kuna mtu
stood in the gap and prayed.
Ambaye simama kwenye pengo na
prayed very hard.
Akaomba zaidi.
His prayer
na maombi
yake rotten enough heat
yakaleta joto la kutosha.
We discover later on,
maana tukagundua baadaye,
the children of Israel,
wana wa Israeli,
were redeemed from captivity,
walikombolewa kutoka kwa ufungwa,
because of the prayer,
kwa sababu ya maombi
that Daniel made,
ambao Danieli aliomba.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana sifiwe.
I want to submit to us today,
nataka nielekeshe leo,
God has has raised you.
Ni kwamba Mungu anakuinua.
In the family where you are.
Katika familia
yako. God has raised you.
Mungu amekuinua.
In the environment where you are.
Mazingira ambayo unania.
In this conference.
Katika kongamano.
We are talking about truthfulness.
Tunazungumza kuhusu
Tanzania. Where you can cause truthfulness.
Ili uweze kuzaliwa chee.
In the family where you are.
Katika familia
yako. You understand you are there by God's purposes.
Ni kwamba wewe uko pale kwa makusudi ya Mungu.
You are there because God planned you to be there.
Pale kama Mungu
alikuinua.
Hauko pale tu pale kiaje.
What do you don't understand?
Chama moja kwa
moja. You are the prophet of God.
Wewe ni nabii wa
Mungu. Kani tu where you are.
Maana hapo kuko.
Are we there?
Je, tuko pale?
Only that you don't understand.
Kwa vile tu hauwezi.
I want to charge us today.
Nataka kwa tie
mambo. We need to pray. To understand what is our wrong.
Tuelewe kazi
yetu. Where we are staying
today. Maana hapo tunaishi
leo. In the family where we come from.
Katika familia zetu.
In the village where you come from.
Katika vijiji
vyetu.
Katika kazi yako.
In a fun way you're working.
Maana hapo unafanya
kazi. Then what is your role?
Uendewe kazi yako
nini? God,
maana Mungu
planted you there.
Amekupanda pale.
And he's depending upon you.
Na anakutegemea
wewe. So that transformation
and let him mabadiliko.
And if we can be able to understand.
Na iwapo tuelewa.
And I'm telling people.
Waambia watu
where I'm working.
Maana hapo unafanya
kazi. There's party time.
Niko pale tu
permanently. But permanently.
Lakini kwa kudumu
I'm there to fulfill God's purpose.
Niko pale kukamilisha makusudi yake.
That's why
na ndio maana
I work.
Ninafanya
in the vineyard of God.
Nafanya kazi katika
kazi. With a lot of energy.
Kwa nguvu nyingi.
Praise the Lord.
Bwana asifiwe.
Somebody was saying.
Mtu alikuwa anasema.
Wewe jamaa tunaomba tuende tuanifanye.
Wewe jamaa tunaomba pili kwanza.
Ametukalia hapa sana. Alikuwa anasema kwa sababu ninamjua yeye ni apo katika ulimwengu mwingine. Bwana asifiwe.
Yeah.
So alikuwa anasema wewe jamaa ukifanya hivi ameinua katika mambo vitu zetu tunafanya nini? Tunaharibika. Kwa hiyo tunaomba aende nini? Tuamfuate gani. So alisema wengine wakisikia. Okay, mimi nikasema nilikuwa nitaondoka hapa kama baba aliyeniweka hapa ameniamrisha nifanye nini? Niondoke. Kama hajasema siondoke. Kwa sababu niko hapo kutenda makusudi ya Mungu. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
I was saying somebody.
Unamwambia mtu.
I am an arrogant believer.
Mimi ni mwamini ambaye kidogo na kiburi.
I do not care.
Sijali.
Not care ile ya kutojali maslahi ya watu. I do not care.
Mimi sina shida.
How you look at me.
Mimi mwenyewe
in line of my salvation.
Kulingana na wokovu wangu.
Praise the Lord.
Barasikimu.
As long as I'm doing the will of God.
Rati na chana mapenzi.
And I'm pursuing the purpose of God.
Na nafuata makusudi ya Mungu.
Praise the Lord.
Barasikimu.
You stand on my way.
Ukisimama kwenye njia.
You experience the heat of God.
Basi utahisi moto.
Praise the Lord.
Barasikimu.
Because God has planted me there.
Maana Mungu amenipanda pale.
And I know I've been planted there.
Na najua nimepandwa pale.
Sometimes.
Wakati mwingine.
When you are in a video.
Kama uko mahala kuna.
The devil may doubt your legality.
Wakati adui anaweza kuja kwa nafasi.
We doubt your legality there.
Anaweza kataa kwa kwako pale.
There is what we call as the mandate in the spiritual realm and the legal covenant.
Kuna kitu ambacho tunaenda katika ulimwengu wa kiroho mahali ambapo umekubaliwa
kuwa. Na hayo tunaongea sana siku nyingine lakini nataka kufikia kidogo na kumaliza. That when I come in your family,
ninapokuja katika familia yako
to look for an action in your family.
Ama kuna maombi katika familia yako.
I may not have a higher mandate, my mandate, high authority.
Wenda sina mamlaka ya juu.
Over some issues in your family.
Juu ya mambo fulani katika familia yako.
The way you is a son or a daughter in that family.
Jinsi wewe mwenyewe kama mwana mabinti katika ile familia.
You have an authority.
Una mamlaka.
There's a level you reach if you become serious with your life.
Kuna sehemu ambayo utafika ukiwa ukimaanisha kuishi.
More than you who is a stranger in your family.
Zaidi ya mimi ambaye ni mgeni katika familia yako.
I can reach.
Mimi naweza fika.
But I don't tell people.
Wanasema hivi.
In that respect.
Katika heshima.
I become a midwife.
Mimi nakuwa kama mtu katika.
I help you.
Na kusaidia.
But you push the baby.
Lakini unasukuma.
You push the baby.
Nakusaidia lakini unasukuma mtu.
And then I tell you push.
Push.
Sukuma. And you push.
Na sukuma.
And you're the one who determine.
Na wewe utakapofika.
Whether that baby will come out.
Kama wewe mtoto atatoka
nje.
Au la.
Sasa tunashindwa kusukuma tutafanya operation sasa. Sasa hivi tutafanya operation na kesho tunasoma siku nyingine. Can I say the way? Yeah, if I find your operation, my face is here. Spiritual is here.
What's wrong with that?
Why can't you show me? Don't know any. So, there is a way also.
When another pain.
When you are in a given ground.
You are mahala.
The other day I was telling a pastor friend.
I'm going to give him to my dad.
Whom we planted somewhere in Hamisi.
I think I'm going to be part of my Hamisi.
I was telling him.
I'm going to be.
I want you to be. You are a stranger in the land.
We will gain it after all the
but I want you to gain a legal ground.
I can't talk about the shaman about it.
Gain a legal ground.
I will put my hand up on a Kubalika.
To fight some battles.
Upigana vita plan.
And the first thing you do,
keep the ones that fire.
Look for money.
To put a base
and buy land.
No, we will not.
Look for money.
Tafuta pesa
and buy land.
Namushaba.
The money you are giving to the poor of the land and it's costing you to stay there. Number one, because you own land, you'll be having a legal ground. Because now, legally, you are an occupant of the land.
Am I
supposed to be here? Who led that wakati to a mystery? Inasemekana kwamba wa Misri walifika mahali wakatumia pesa zao wakamaliza wakafanya wakati wa njaa. Alafu wakafika mahali serikali ikaanza kunyonga shamba yao. Mistake information. I charge you to read the whole Bible. So we will be able to be here. So we will be able to come and story. So we will be able to come and story. So we will be able to come and story. Come and story to and get the flow. Are you there? Do you know? Basically, what the king was doing, he was denying the Egyptians the legal rights to be the owners of that nation. That's a story for another day. I'm using it to explain my point. So I told him, buy land. Once you go the land, you are there now. And you stay there. Put the church there. Put your house there. When you stand, you say by the authority
that's
told upon me through the death of our Lord Jesus Christ, the enemy will be scared. Because today when I was praying for the environment where I stay, the spirit of God laid upon my heart. The enemy is the down to legality. I went before God. God is a judge. And I told God, sit on your seat of judgment and make this case clear. I'm here in this land by the appointment of the government of Kenya. I have my appointment letter. I did not just come here,
but
the government of Kenya knows I'm here. Number two, I've been empowered by my faithful.
And
given an appointment letter,
nimepatiwa barua ya
to be the patron of the Christian Union.
Kuwa mkuu katika idara ya Kristo.
Number three,
tatu,
I've been in this land long enough.
Nimekuwa hapa kwa muda wa kutosha.
To be assimilated.
Ili nisije nikadanganyika.
Are we there?
Barani,
I won the case.
Nikashinda kesi.
In the spiritual realm.
Katika ulimwengu wa kiroho.
Unajua tujui tunapoenda kuomba, kuna wakati una negotiate. Una negotiate. In the Exodus chapter 33,
kutoka 33,
unajua Musa anaambia Mungu, nataka uwepo wako uende pamoja na mimi. Na anamwambia namna gani? Remember, this nation is your nation.
Taifa hili ndio.
Sisi tukienda kwa Mungu tunaombanga namna gani? Unaambia Mungu, Mungu kwanza mimi umenikomboa kwa damu yako, nimekukubali kama mwana wako. Si ndio? Nimeokoka, nimekiri Yesu Kristo kuwa mwokozi wa maisha yangu. Kwa hivyo mimi ni mwana wako. Nimeoshwa kwa damu takatifu. Sawa sawa. Alafu baadaye unaendelea. When you raise the case.
Unaleta mambo yako.
You raise your case. Because the enemy also goes before God to raise what? The case. Na kuna wakati na shida case umejengwa because you don't give enough evidence.
Okay, ni mshahidi wa kutosha.
Are we there? Yeah. You give enough evidence.
Ni mshahidi wa kutosha.
I was praying for somebody. I want to finish it there now. I was praying for somebody.
When I'm going to.
Yeah,
who was demon possessed. And I had prayed for the person for some time. And then I got alone. And I went in the Bible. There are several scriptures that you found God as a judge. I told God, God, I pray to you. Sit on your seat of judgment. And I went to present that case before you. And I went before God. And I told God, I pray that you release Jesus Christ to be the advocate in this case. And your angels will be ministers in this court. Are we there? And I read a few scriptures based on the issue I was handling. And I told God, by virtue of this scripture and this scripture and this scripture, and I titled it to the righteous judgment in my favor. And now listen to this. A, I'm referring to the person as A because I don't want to say the name. Mary, one has confessed Christ. Number two, he has accepted Jesus Christ to be the Lord and Savior of his life. Praise the Lord. Number three, he has been washed, he has repented and been washed by the blood. The area of deliverance in her life that I had not reached, I reached that day.
So him, you composed it for me.
I told God, now release your judgment.
Achieve
your
hukumu yako.
And as you release your judgment, release the heavenly executors.
Achilia wale wakunyonga kutoka
of your judgment now to come down.
Ili hukumu yako ipite chini.
Bila nisema hivyo nikaona akabadilika na mapepo yakaanza kutoka na yakatoka in the deliverance process was completed. Praise the Lord. It begins with the heart of God. Comes down. Now what I'm sharing right now is the knowledge on how to go before God now. Travailing. Like when it comes down to the issue of travailing. Tunashindwa, we don't know how to present the case. Mungu baba nakushukuru. Naomba unisaidie hii kitu. Unisaidie ni kwa The enemy will challenge you before God. He does not deserve this. He was telling us the devil is a legal entity. And he said, oh, you need to handle it legally. Now, utashangaa, if you handle it legally, in a joke, and you've been praying for the last 5 years. Because he's a big entity. What has to do? Ona kumuka wakatavena vele ayubu. Una vele ayubu. Uusu ayubu. Akasema wewe, kwa sababu umemulida. Toa your friends ya bawa umemwekea. Alafu atafanya na mna gani. Ata kulaani. What has to do? Do you know he was looking for the ground? Yeah. And he wanted legally, he wanted to prove to God that Job was a hypocrite. And he was only serving God because of the protection. Are we there? The case is with us, in our lives. Not with struggling. There's a situation I was saying. Sometimes we pray for people who have cancer and arthritis. We call Psalms chapter 103 verse
3.
God has forgiven us of all our sins. And healed us of all our diseases. We
quote
Isaiah 53 verse 5. By our stripes we are healed. And then because we seek God about it, we go to this in our spirit. This person is bitter.
When you talk to the person about bitterness, and you handle bitterness, and arthritis disappears, and cancer disappears, what is the legal ground? Bitterness. Shetani anaenda mbele ya Mungu. Wewe unaomba na shetani anaionyesha mbele ya Mungu. Anasema huyu ni wangu. Uweze kumponya hii kitu.
Amen.
You are nito. If you understand, I want to spice up on my feet.
What's the matter with you?
You don't think it's supposed to be. Come to believe you have been encouraged. You have been enlightened. Remember what I said, prayer begins from the heart of God. It has set in the heart of man. Being taken back to God. What happens? God responds in prayer. Once again, I want us to make a prayer. This morning, I want us to pray. That God will give us wisdom. God will give us understanding. I want us to pray. That God will sharpen our discernment in the Spirit.
When we pray to
understand the things of the Spirit,
when we have to be alone,
so that we handle them with understanding.
Even if we make it over hard,
praise the Lord.
When I say,
open my sense of taste, open my sense of touch. And allow me to hear you. Allow me to be connected to you. Allow me to understand you. In the name of our Lord Jesus. Jesus, open your mouth and begin to pray. And the Spirit of God is you. In the name of Jesus. Father, we give you praise to God. We have to be to you. In the name of Jesus, the Lord Jesus. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, we worship you, Lord. 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 Lord, open our eyes to understanding. Lord, open our eyes. Someone lift up your voice today. Father, give me understanding to the spiritual realm. Give me understanding. Lord, open my eyes to understanding. Open my eyes to understanding. Father, we pray tonight in Jesus' name. Open our eyes to understanding. Lord, give us the wisdom to the Spirit. Come on.
What did he say? Verses 1. Blessed be that. Then he did what? Spoke a parable to them that men always ought to do what? Pray and not lose heart. God. There was a certain, in a certain city, a judge who did not fear God, nor regard man. Okay? Now there was also a widow in that city that she came to him saying, get justice for me, for my adversary. And he would not for a while, but afterwards says within himself, God did not fear God, nor judge, nor regard. Yet because this widow troubles me, I will avenge her, lest by a continual coming she wears me. Praise the Lord. Now, Jesus gives that parable.
This would have been a parable.
A parable, we don't know what parable is
like.
Now, it gives a picture of a judge who is a wicked one.
A man just feel like I can't live by the day.
But there is also a judge who is a righteous judge, who is our father that our brothers just been teaching about. We have a God who is a judge.
You
say your neighbor, we have a God who is a judge. Jesus is a what? Our advocate.
Yes, we are killing him.
A certain is a what? Yeah, the prosecutor who prosecutes us before the Father.
No,
a brother was teaching saying that what? There are some prayers that we don't get a breakthrough. Because the eternal authorities work on the basis of iniquity in your lineage. They stand before God and say, Lord, you are a God of judge, of justice. You look at this man. Look at this man. He can't qualify for this. Because of this iniquity. This iniquity. That thing happens in the book of Zechariah chapter 5. In other chapters we have. Satan thrives on sin. But we thrive on righteousness. Praise the Lord. On the blood of Jesus Christ. On the cross of Jesus. That when Jesus went at the cross, he finished it. This morning the brothers have shared about God as a judge. We can approach to his throne.
Now,
there are many ways you can approach God. One is as a father. As our God. As our friend.
We can
also approach him as a judge. There are things in our lives. We must come to the court of heaven.
And
say, Lord, on this matter, we invoke your judicial powers that you make your judgment not based on how righteous I am, but on the righteousness of Jesus and the blood that is shed for us at the cross. And the Lord will give you justice. God will give you justice. Talk to neighbor. This morning, the time to get justice.
We need
to get justice. There's some things you pray for. For many days. For many years. Approaching God as a friend. Approaching God as a father. But today, you want to approach him as a dad. Let him make the judgment. Not based on my righteousness, but on the righteousness of Jesus Christ.
He
said, Lord, grant it in Jesus' name. The woman went to the judge.
He
says, you must give me justice.
You
must give me justice.
And
the man gave the woman justice because the woman was going to wear out. But God is going to give us justice faster. Because we belong to Jesus. We belong to Jesus. And because of the righteousness of God in our lives,
He's
going to grant us. That's why we celebrate Easter. There was a divine exchange that He took
tomoi our feet.
Alichukua dhambi zetu.
And he gave us his righteousness.
Akatupatia haki.
That through his righteousness,
kwa haki yake,
we can stand before the Father.
Tunaweza kusimama mbele za Baba.
And this righteousness has given us a right standing in the heavens.
Hii haki imetupatia mahali pa
kusimama. Whatever we ask in the name of Jesus.
Tunaitisha kwa jina la Yesu.
We can receive this.
So we can kupokea siku hii.
I want you to present your case.
Nataka ulete mambo yako.
Your case.
Mambo yako.
Unaona ukweli huo?
Wewe usiombe.
Have you ever gone to a court?
No. We shared it to the court.
You've had the introduction, introductory remarks by the advocates.
Unaona vile
yamejisikiza. My Lord.
Sema bwana wangu.
Based on this case.
Kulingana na kesi hii.
I pray. And another use the same verse. I pray. That this case.
The case hii.
Be nullified. Because of what?
Kwa sababu ya hii.
Two and three that I see. And wait for the judge to make his judgment.
Ngoje.
Tonight. Because of the righteousness of Christ.
Kwa sababu ya haki ya Kristo.
Some of you have not been given the rightful place.
Wengine wenu mtapata sehemu ambazo mnastahili.
We want to claim it legally.
Nataka tukazitishe.
Says we are getting it right now in Jesus' name.
Nazipata katika jina.
We are getting it right now in Jesus' name. We are invoking the legal powers.
Tunajisema
Lord, you are a judge.
Sasa Mungu uko
ndani. You are calling it right now.
Uko sasa
hapo. You are calling it to me right now.
Nataka kuona na mimi sasa.
It could be an issue of promotion.
There's a money hand up on your chair.
It could be an issue that you battle for days.
After we're handing at
the issue of your health.
Hand up on your
hand. He says, if you obey me,
and I send a weapon on your
team, I will take away
the town door.
I will not allow the infirmities of the Jesus to come in with
us. It's a loose man and a kubati.
Lord, I obey your word.
Mungu natimbe na
these fibroids.
I move in
the most high in Jesus. I stand before your throne.
Give us a new identity. Thank you. Oh,
children and above 100
married. 7 years
and above. 100
married.
I see an additional decree being made over you. You shall be married. 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 Even though sit in our
seat, at a moment in India,
it's the only opportunity.
Even a person
to excel in the bath.
God of justice,
Mungu wa haki,
and God,
wewe ni Mungu
You alone, when we pick it up, gives us power to make wealth.
Alone.